Why is the integral of 1 over x ln x plus c? In particular, we would like to know, is it possible to explain it step by step without just saying what is something you derive that gives you 1 over x? So here is how I will explain this right here. First, I will have to assume that we already have the exponential function, so let me write that down. So suppose if we already have the exponential function e to the x. So of course right here you also need to know what the number e is, and you should also give a definition for it, and also the inverse of e to the x is ln x, right? So based on this assumption, we can do the following. And in fact, I have done a video on talking about what's the number e and also the exponential function. So you can start with this right here first, all right? So if we have this right here already, then we can really look at the integral of 1 over x as follows. For this right here, let me just look at the case that when x is greater than 0, and this is how we can do it. I'm just going to first take a substitution. I'm going to let x equal to e to some variable. Of course, we have used x right here already, so I cannot put down x. So I'm going to use, say, t, right? Let x is equal to e to the t. And then we will just have to do the usual business, because here we have the dx. So we need to get the dx from this equation as well. And to do so, we just differentiate both sides, and we'll get dx equals the derivative of e to the t is just e to the t times dt. And as you can see, the reason that I really have to make x greater than 0 is because e to the t is always positive, right? So that's why. And now we can just take this integral to the u world. Have a look. Here we have the integral 1 over x. The x is e to the t, so I will just put that for the x. And then dx is e to the t dt. So I can also put that down right here. How's that? And this is so wonderful because e to the t cancel. And we're just looking at the integral of 1 in the t world. What's the integral of 1 in the t world? Well, it's just t. And then of course you can put down a plus e right here. But we're not done yet because we also have to go back to the x world. But now have a look. We know x is equal to e to the t, and we know that the exponential function's inverse is natural log. So from here we can say t equals natural log of x. Yes, and right here we can just say that this is equal to ln x and then plus c. That said, we are done. So this is how we can explain it. But again, you will have to first define what exponential function is, and then the number e, and then build out the connection between the inverse of e to the x is ln x in order for this argument to work. However, historically speaking though, I will have to talk about this. So this is just based on history. The integral, sorry, based on history, when we have ln x, it was actually first defined to be in terms of integral, and that's the integral going from 1 to x of 1 over some variable, let's just say t dt. And here I will have to say that x is greater than 0. And you might be wondering, what if x is equal to 1 half? Does it work? Yes, if you have the integral going from 1 to 1 half, the result of that integral will just be negative, so that's still legit. But anyway, this is how, historically speaking, how ln of x was defined in the first place. And it was really just to find the area under 1 over t, which is like this. And let's say we have a 1 right here. And then let's say x is right here. This area gives you ln x. And if you have an x value that's in between of 0 and 1, let's say somewhere right here, this is also ln x, but the result that will be negative. So that's that. And of course, if you use this definition, then you can say that the integral of 1 over t or whatever, you just get natural log. So you are done. So it depends on what you have first. So there you have it. Hopefully this right here helps. And let me know if you guys have any more questions. And that's it.